It's about a platoon of American soldiers. It's set in the infected zone from the first film. It's expanded, the infected zone, and this focuses on the Middle East area of that. And it's, yeah, this platoon of soldiers. They're two. We kind of focus on two of them. One of them's a young rookie, first tour in, full of it, wants it, is going out to try and find himself, escaping poverty. He grows up in Detroit, where there's not a lot going on, and joins the army, full of it. Thinks he's justified in going to fight for the right cause, and then when he gets there, he meets an older soldier, who I play, Noah Freighter, and he's coming to the end of his time, I think, and I think he can see that. He knows that's, he can see it, and it's kind of a road movie in a way, you know, like the two of them end up going on this journey and kind of exploring themselves through each other, and trying to work it all out, you know, under really extreme circumstances.
I've seen the original Monsters, and I thought it was one of the most innovative pieces of filmmaking I'd seen for a while, and I just felt that the building blocks were there for this sort of freedom to go and create a world and build on the ethos of that filmmaking, and build a world of a great scale, and sort of use the film as an interesting metaphor to tell a new and different story with.
I'd heard of the first movie, I hadn't seen it before I sort of was made aware of the Dark Continent, and then having watched the first movie, it was something that I just wanted to be a part of. You know, I think it's a great film, and I think that, and having spoken to Tom and the creative team behind it, you know, they were really keen to sort of continue that ethos and to very much keep the same, you know, the spirit of the original film, but, you know, to make something completely different.
The fans of the first film will still get that intimacy, that human story that I think a lot of people, the fans of the film, really connected with, and we've been really true to that principle, and I know that still remains at the heart of this film, but they also get a lot of genre elements. It's a war film up front, you know, and we also have a lot of science fiction elements, so it's they get a lot of, it's not a small film, they're going to get a lot of ideas, a lot of spectacle, but also that integral human story.
Particularly in Britain, we don't tend to make films like this. It's got such ambition, and the scale of it, I think, will really impress people too. I think we're at the heart of it all, just some great characters. I mean, the performances from the guys that I was working with are just phenomenal, some of them, and there's something in it for everyone, I think.
To be honest, it's got a bit of everything. I really mean that. It's kind of big and explosive because it's a film about war, and it's set in the field of war, and some of the set pieces, you know, they're very authentic. We had a great military guy with us, CK Redlinger, an amazing guy. He was with us every step of the way, so it's very authentic. The set pieces, the battle scenes are big, explosive, but it's got those lovely intimate moments from the first film as well, about two people trying to connect and are unable to.